Now, before I go tonight, I want to discuss a story that has disappeared from international headlines but deserves our attention. For over 100 days now, Iran has seen people take to the streets protesting the brutal and archaic policies of their government. And these aren't protesters like Extinction Rebellion, which call themselves brave, knowing there are no real consequences for their actions. These are protesters who risk their death every time they go on the streets. So after these 100 days, what is the latest with these protests and where are the international feminist movement? Where is the outcry? Human rights advocate and someone who's paying very close attention to this situation in Iran, Dr. Minoo Ghamari, joins me now in the studio. Welcome.
Thank you.
It's 100 days of protest, Minoo, and it's not slowing down. Can these protests actually result in any meaningful change?
Yes, and they already have. The fact that women in Iran walk around without headscarf in many, many towns and cities already is a big change. But we need to remember that this revolution is what it is. It's not about headscarf, religion. People at this stage want a fundamental regime change.
I mean, many of these protesters have already died, we should note, and yet thousands are still ready to stand up for their fundamental human rights. It's pretty inspiring to see people take matters into their own hands and stand up for what they believe in a situation like this. I mean, this is an example of true bravery, isn't it?
It really is. It is incredible. I mean, around the world, we all stood up in solidarity with people of Iran. We still do. In so many cases, even in our Melbourne, there have been protests day and night happening. But it's nothing compared to what people of Iran are doing for their basic human rights. They go out bare hands against shotguns. And let's remember that many unthinkable things can happen to them and their families. But they have been fed up. They want fundamental change. And what was at the beginning just a protest for human rights now is a full-on revolution.